Hi, David here, CEO and founder of the Freedom Founders Mastermind Community. A lot of people ask me, David, where are you putting your capital investments today? You talk a lot about how the market's rolling over. We're in a course correction right now. We're looking really deep into a recession. The higher cost of capital is changing the market dynamics. What are you doing today? You've gone through a lot of cycles. I have. I started investing when I was 22 back in 1980. So yeah, that's a lot of years. That's over 40 years of investing through various cycles, primarily in alternative investments. Besides my own business, my own professional practice, which I managed and operated for a number of years through various cycles, I've also been investing in real estate for now 43 years. So I've seen the cycles. I understand them. I don't have perfect timing with those cycles, but I do know what happens when we go through a market cycle, and we are in one right now. We're turning over right now. Now, there's different pundits who talk about soft landing, with the bottoms here, we turn the corner, things are going to go back, we'll see interest rates go down, and then all will be good. And it's okay, people can have their own opinion. I take a counterpoint. When there's a saturation of opinion on one side, which there seems to be, that everything's going to be okay and that the worst is behind us, I tend to look the other way. And I found in life that even though I could be wrong, I'd rather be more on the conservative side and protect my capital, my principal, because even if I am wrong and I miss a little bit more of the highs that may still come in the marketplace, because the Federal Reserve and Congress tend to kick the can down the road over and over, but they're running out of steam, and that's my point. And I believe when we have the correction, and I think we're going to roll into it the next quarter or two before the end of this year, into 2024, into 2025, the correction that we will be looking at, staring in the face, will be relatively dramatic. Now, as much as 2008, can't predict. I think it could be. If that's the case, when you lose equity, when you lose principal in your various accounts, your investments that you were relying on, that can set you back years. It can set you back a decade or more. Back in the dot-com crash, the NASDAQ took 15 years to recover. 15 years to recover. So it's wonderful to see the great returns that we've seen in the financial products, in alternatives, crypto, whatever you want to call it, for the last few years. Well, that's wonderful. If you don't know how to convert the profit or take the chips off the table at the right time, go to higher ground, and then turn that capital investment into income, which is what, in essence, we all need, replacement income, not just net worth, not just piled up, but we need income to make that income work. Where do I go right now? Higher ground for me is in cash or near cash equivalents. What does that mean? Today, you should know that you can put money in short-term treasury bills, which are basically risk-free. At 5.5% today. We haven't seen that in 15, 16 years, that rate of return on risk-free treasury bills. Now you might say, well, okay, David, 5.5%, but you know, inflation's still probably running at least that today, so I'm breaking even. Yeah, that may be the case. So where do I go next? Well, I still stay in the debt as an asset part of the capital stack. Capital stack, basically, there's two parts. There's the debt portion, and there's the equity portion. For most of the time, when there's an up market or bull market, we want to be in the equity side. We want to own stuff, right? Ownership. That's where we get the tax benefits. That's where we get the inflation hedge. That's where we can do the value add and where the profits come from. It's all been good, good, good. But right now, that equity is at risk. And I think we're going to see it squeezed and drop to some degree over the next quarters into the next year, 2 years. So I'd rather be on the debt side, acting as a bank, being a lender. You say, well, David, how do you do that? I mean, who do you lend money to? Well, again, I use my favorite alternative asset class, and that's real estate. I know how to lend money to operators who need the capital to keep their operations going, particularly as interest rates have been climbing, as the credit markets, the banks, the lending institutions are cutting back on the amount of loans that they are making today because of the cost of capital and the lack of liquidity in the marketplace. It's a perfect time to be a lender because I get what's called first money out. Well, think about it. When you borrow money from the bank to buy something, a house, a commercial property, the bank always gets paid first. Whatever the interest rate is, they get paid first, and then you as the owner get paid second. I want to be first money out when we're going through a market correction. So who do I lend to? Well, this is the beauty of alternative investments, particularly real estate, because it's an inefficient marketplace. The secondary market, the ability for people like us as retail investors to lend our money to vetted borrowers with real estate backing it, real estate that we like, that we do the due diligence on, the opportunity is huge today. It's and there's many reasons why it is. I won't go into the details, but it's huge today. most people don't understand this part of the real estate capital stack, the debt side. Don't understand it, have never done it, don't know how to do it because they've only known equities. So you've got to be in a place where you can reposition your capital when you go through market cycles, particularly going into a recession or correction. You've got to understand how to do this. Otherwise, if you just sit with your equities and don't make a move, don't take the chips off the table at the right time, then you risk the loss of principal, which, it, again, can take years. I mean, it can take a decade or more to regain that. Do you really want to do that? This is what we do in Freedom Founders. This is the connections, the access points, the wisdom, the collective brain trust that we have formed in Freedom Founders over the last 12, 13 years. This is where we get to put our capital. This is a time when you need to understand how to position yourself for the future, not just right now during this correction, but because you want to know how to be your best financial advocate going down the road years from now, a decade from now, two decades from now. These are skill sets that you can take to the bank all day long if you just know what to do. It's your freedom. You got to stay focused on it. See you next time.